Welcome to the channel. I'm starting a new series, Beginner's Guide to VBA. With this being the first video, we'll go over some setup and some details that will be important for setting up macros and permissions on your files, as you want to be careful with macros. If you receive a file from someone you do not know, you will not want macros to be enabled because people are able to embed viruses in them. So you have to be careful with that. But for learning VBA and learning how to use it, we'll go over some ranges and also the parts of VBA, such as objects and properties, and when they're applicable. But we'll try to keep it simple and beginner friendly and give you some more knowledge so you can work on your VBA and get better at coding and start making some impressive macros. And with that being said, let's go over some setup and the difference between a macro-enabled workbook and a normal Excel workbook, and also how to put a permission on your files so you are not the victim of a viral attack through macros. So if we just go up to File and Save As, the Save As type will be an Excel workbook. There's also macro enabled. So if you save it as a macro enabled, the next time you open it, it will ask you if you would like to enable macros, if there are any in the file. In which case you'd say yes if you know who the author is and you're comfortable with all the macros. So if we save this as a macro enabled one, we're now able to include macros in this file. So if we click File again and go down to Options, go to Trust Center, Trust Center Settings, and go to Macro Settings. You will want Disable VBA Macros with Notification. This will be the pop-up when you open a macro-enabled file that will say, would you like to enable macros? If you do not know the author, this is when you'd want to click No. If you're comfortable with the file, you can click Yes, and now macros will be able to run in this workbook. And so now to get started with VBA in macros, we're going to want to go to our ribbon and right-click anywhere where there's not a button and hit customize the ribbon. And on the right side, we will want to click the check mark for developer, which will open our VBA window that we can either record macros, view our macros, or open Visual Basic. So if you open Visual Basic, you can hit view code. This will be for this workbook and this worksheet that we have selected. If you hit View Object, it will take you back to the object that you have selected, which is Sheet 1. And so if you were to record a macro, it would be related to this object, which would be this current sheet. And I do think it's important for someone learning to code, especially VBA. It is nice to record macros and see the code that is recorded and even edit them. Because in a lot of cases, you can record small macros to do repetitive tasks for you. But for now, let's go over object-oriented programming, which is what VBA is, and give you some basics just so you know what's going on in the code before we start to write it. So this is from Microsoft's website. If you look up Visual Basic Guide for VBA, and here's object-oriented programming in Visual Basic. So it'll go over classes and objects and different things. You can go through all these, and it gets into constructors and how to create methods for objects. I would say that this is a bit advanced. As you go through, you'll learn some of this stuff, and this is a great resource. I'll leave links to any websites that I mention so you can learn, and reading all this stuff will give you a very good basis for programming in general, and especially Visual Basic. But when we're talking about VBA specifically, I like to use these analogies for object collections, methods, parameters, and properties. We can go over examples as they come up, and for this video we'll introduce you. So you can think of an object as like a cell or a sheet or a workbook, which will be like ranges or the actual application itself. When you open a sheet or a cell that you select, will be the object, and the collection will specify this. So think of a noun, plural noun. So it'll be worksheets, and then the actual worksheet itself will be the object, but it is specifying which one. Methods will be verbs, That will be object dot method. It'll be an action of the object. An adverb, you can think of a parameter. They'll be listed after the method, and use a colon, an equal sign to separate the parameters from the value. We'll get into different methods and parameters of objects as we go along in VBA. In properties, be the adjective to describe, you can set it. Example, the cell height you can set to a certain size. So you will give that property to the object. And I know that's a lot of information to take in, but as you get into coding, those will make sense. So let's get started, and we'll get some data from a text/CSV file. To go over some macros that we can record, so we can get rid of this table, make these all just normal formatting. So for this example, we brought in data that has an ID, gender, if they're married, age, graduated profession, work experience, spending score, family size, some different variables, their category and what segment they're in. And this could be something that whatever reports you build or whatever data you're trying to analyze, an easy way to record a macro will be if we're in the developer tab, click record macro. You can also click use relative reference. So relative reference will be like, so if we start in A1, and record this macro, let's say for this macro, we'll just take this column and switch it with this column. That if we move this data, let's say over to here, if we start in this cell, it won't work because the relative reference will be like whatever cell we have selected here. It will move this cell, whereas non-relative reference, so if we uncheck relative reference, it will always be B no matter what, as compared to relative reference, where if we start in A, it will do this column, start in B, it will do this column. Non-relative will mean it will do B no matter what. So with that being said, we can record a macro where we will not use relative reference. So we will hit record. And the name will be what you want to name it. We could do formatting. You can also make a shortcut here, which you can make this like Control G or Control H, not like Control C or V, like ones that you use very often, or Control S to save, because then that will override the copy and paste or the saving shortcuts. So you can store this in this workbook. You could also store it in your personal macro workbook, so it's available with every Excel sheet that you open and every single workbook that you use. So we can just save it in this workbook. Click OK. Description can be format our report. So when we click OK, so say we want to switch the ID and gender tabs or columns. So what we can do is insert and then just move this. And delete that, and maybe we could get rid of these, let's say, and then stop recording. Okay, so now if we use Control Z to undo this, this is the data that we loaded in. Now let's go to macros, formatting, let's run it. It will automatically format, delete our cells, and switch these. So now if you click on macros, the one that shows up is formatting, and you can click step into to view it. So now the way macros are set up, that it will always be sub, which is declaring the macro, and then formatting is what you name it, along with parentheses in here that you can add stuff to, but we won't worry about that. So this is our comments, that is formatting macro to format our report. So columns, A to A dot select, that's selecting this whole column, And the select is pretty much, you know, selecting the columns or highlighting them. So selection.insert, which is inserting a column to the left. So it's moving this over to the right. And columns C to C dot select, and then us dragging them over is a cut and paste. So then we delete those columns that we selected, and then we end with selecting A1. So now we go over range and selections, and also some syntax that's deleting and stuff like that. So we recorded our first macro, and if we saved it in our personal macro workbook, any Excel file that we open, it will be available to. So that is a quick way just to format reports easily and, you know, save yourself some time.